Namaste to all dear students. Here I am with a new video relating to managerial accounting and introduction, and today's topic is scope of management accounting. Okay, so let us discuss the what is the scope of management accounting in detail. So scope means what? Scope means general meaning, area, or you can say range, okay, or relationship related, okay. So here in this concept or topic, we are going to discuss how management accounting or managerial accounting has relationship with the other disciplines like financial accounting, cost accounting, budgeting and forecasting, data processing, internal auditing, tax reporting, financial analysis, inventory control, revaluation of account in statistical methods, other things, because management accounting is always deals with the decision making, and to make the decision it requires information or data. The data which is processed, okay, will be taken from the financial accounting and cost accounting for the purpose of objectives of the organization. Whatever objectives of organization are there, those should be fulfilled. So to make or to achieve those objectives, what management accounting will deal, management accounting will do, they will have relationship with the these all things are nothing but some are functions of management accounting. So budgeting, data processing, internal audit, tax planning, financial analysis, inventory control, because all these are interrelated with the each and every objective of the organization. So statistical methods based on the information relation, you see correlation, regression analysis, all these are having some relationship with the decision making. When price of a product has to be decided, okay, what should be the selling price, to decide that some information, statistical data is required. So management accounting to make a decision whether to produce a new product or not, to make like these decisions, management accounting requires some other disciplines like statistical, financial accounting, cost accounting, budgeting and forecasting, all these. So let us discuss all these things in detail now. A brief intro I have been given just now, so let us discuss this in detail. So here we are having scope of management accounting related notes. Let us see in detail now. Scope of management accounting. Scope of management accounting. The scope of management accounting covers all information that can be used by managers in decision making. Just now whatever I have briefly described or explained, the same thing is given in this three paragraph. Let us see those things. The decisions with which managers are concerned can be classified as planning decisions, organizing decisions and controlling decisions. So management makes the decisions. Those decisions are relating to planning, organizing and controlling. Planning decisions are concerned with the establishment of goals of the organization. In planning, we need to plan our goals, which are objectives which have to be achieved during the period. So choice of plan to accomplish these goals, and not only goals, we need to see, we need to make the goal, establishment of goal. When you are having goals, to achieve those goals, you may be having plans, different plans, plan A, B, C, which one will be better. So we need to make a choice of those plans. Examples of decisions for which management accounting information is included in decisions like whether to purchase or produce a component. Suppose a company needs a component called X. Okay, X is a component which it uses to produce product A. So company can purchase that product at open market, or it can make that product by itself. Whether to make or purchase, for that a decision has to be taken after, out of two. To make those decision, it requires some information. For that, it will go for accounting information. So that based on the accounting information, it will make a decision. So whether particular department should be carried on or hived off. Sometimes one department is doing better, other department is not doing better. So which department to be continued, which department should be stopped or suspended or discontinued, like this decision has to be taken. There is a separate topic called decision making, your third unit. In that unit we are going to discuss these things in detail. For that purpose, management requires decisions. For that purpose, it requires some data from cost accounts and financial accounts. That is what here the major thing in this paragraph they are saying. Next, we are having one more thing. Organization decisions involves optimization of available human and non-human resources to achieve organization's objectives. Okay, management is means what? Managing M. That is what? Managing M means money, machine, and manpower. That is, human resources and non-human resources have to be optimally utilized. To utilize these things, management has to make some decisions. So management accounting is useful in decision regarding number of units of each product that can be used, budgeting of specific amounts to be spent, and sales promotion, etc., are to be done. So how many units we need to produce, how much material it requires, these all will be done through budgeting. So budgeting is a technique, that thing we are going to study in separate chapter, chapter 4 or unit 4 you are having. So management accounting involves budgeting for the purpose of objectives fulfillment of the organization's objectives. So how resources should be planned, organized, then we need to control. So control means what? To see that expenditure should not increase beyond a certain level. So for that, it has to plan or forecast some information, and it will compare with the actuals, with the forecasted or budgeted, And if any deviations are there, those deviations, whether controllable or uncontrollable, they will see and corrective actions will be taken. So controlling decisions, for the purpose of controlling decisions, implementing the plans and monitoring the actual results to see the goals are being achieved. If there is a significant deviation from plan, corrective actions will have to be initiated. That is what I said, no? First, they will establish some standards and budget the things. After that, they will execute the plans, whatever they have already planned. While performing or executing, if there is any deviations from the which already set, so if there is any deviation from the actuals and standards, those things will be corrected, or corrective actions will be initiated, because there may be two things. One is controllable one, some are uncontrollable. Which are in the hands of management are controllable, which are not in the hands of management are uncontrollable. Suppose COVID situation, lockdown situation, these all are uncontrollable. Okay, these all are uncontrollable. So because of that, if there is any reduction in the sales or output which was planned, okay, by the organization, it cannot be done anything, because it has happened all of a sudden. So plan B or plan C, they will come with the other things and they will see that corrective measures will be taken in this situation. So some are controllable, some are uncontrollable. So these things they will take care. Next, examples of decisions where management accounting information is essentially includes manipulation of price to adjust the difference between actual and planned sales, review, economic. These are the different techniques which management accounting will see. Production process runs smoothly, analysis of variance analysis, standard costing, that is another topic you are having in the end. So these are the different things by which management accounting will make sure that its objectives or goals should be achieved. For this purpose, the scope to do these all functions, it has some scope or relationship with the other disciplines or other things which it has to be related or have a link between them. So those things we are going to see now. See, management accounting touches upon number of areas such as following aspects also fall within its scope. One is financial accounting. Historical data presented in financial accounting is the basis for planning the future course of action. Based on the past information, previous year financial reports, balance sheet, P&L and other things, based on those previous information, future actions will be forecasted and planned by the management. So financial accounting is also useful. Next, cost accounting. How cost accounting? Cost accounting provides various techniques such as marginal costing, standard costing, etc., which help the management in number of ways. I said at the beginning itself, costing has three parts: elements, methods and techniques. This marginal costing, standard costing, budgetary control, all these comes under the techniques of costing, and these techniques are generally used by the management for making decisions. So cost accounting also will be helpful for the management. Next, tax accounting or tax planning. tax planning, filing of return with different departments, keeping the management informed, its tax burden falls within the scope of management accounting. What would be the tax should be paid by the organization? This is the decision, this thing will be done by the management accounting itself, not by the financial accounting or cost accounting. Tax related matters comes under the scope of management accounting itself. Timely preparation of returns, filing of returns, all other things, GST returns, monthly returns, annual returns, like that, indirect tax returns they need to file, as well as direct tax returns they need to file at the end of the each year. Next, internal audit. This is very important thing from the management perspective. Internal audit undertaken for the performance appraisal of and strengthening of internal control procedures and as aids to financial statutory audits also comes within the purview of management accounting, because internal auditor is plans his audit and he reports to the management itself. So internal controls, whether internal control procedures are fair enough, whether which department is performing better, for that department there will be some appraisal. So which employee is doing better performance, based on that they will be given incentives or promotions and etc. So these all things will come under the scope of management accounting itself. Next one, budgetary control. Budgetary control, formulation of budgets, their comparison with the actuals and analysis of variances is part of management accounting. We need to budget the things. Suppose you need to produce 10,000 units. How much material is required? What will be the fixed cost? How those amounts will be utilized for various purposes? So budgeting is the task of management accounting, and after budgeting, when they have been executed, I have already said this point, when they already executing, actuals will be compared with the budgeted things. This for this purpose management accounting uses variance analysis, standard costing and variance analysis. With the help of that, if there is any deviation, whether such deviation they will go through, if it is there is a deviation, whether that deviation is within this control of the management or not, they will see, and corrective measurements will be taken. Forecasting means foreseeing the things. Management accounting covers forecasting the future in all possible states of the nature, evaluation of alternatives in the because some one should direct the things. Who will direct? Who has some forecast vision? Okay, how organization should move for this year, and organization as a whole has some mission and vision to achieve those things. Management has to make it objectives, goals. It will convert small parts, and tasks and targets will be given to the employees at lower level. So this forecasting part of management accounting itself. The management accounting reports to the various people who need to make the decisions, like reporting to the management of the various activities of the organization, integral part of accounting, management of accounting. Length of time and interval being depending upon the nature of the information. Some reports annually, some are half yearly, because the based on these reports, future things will be again evaluated and forecasted. So reporting is the part of management accounting. It is made in uniform interval time, like I said, quarterly, monthly, sometimes cash budgets will be prepared quarterly basis, production budget will be prepared half yearly basis or quarterly basis, depending upon the nature and size of the organization, and based on that corrective measurements and things will be taken. Not only that, director's report will be prepared by the management accounting itself, okay, and these will be some like director reports and other things will be served to the shareholders in the general meeting. If it is not a company type of organization, whoever will be the responsible person, to them it will be reported, like partners in case of partnership firm. Other services. Management accounting might also be expected to deal with the data processing, filing, I said data processing, statistical information methods, all these are other functions it will make, communication, etc. in the organization, and report about the utility of different offices and machines. These are the other services. Okay, so hope you have understood the scope of management accounting. There may be chance of getting this question in the exam, so don't leave anything. I am repeatedly saying you all from the beginning, unit 1, okay, total theory unit itself, you people are in lockdown, problems, we can discuss the problems also, but theory unit minimum, what is minimum, 15 plus 4, 19, one long question, one short question. But in COVID situation, you can write two questions from this first unit itself. So 15 plus 15, 30 plus one short question, 34 marks may come from this unit itself. So be careful, learn the things perfectly, don't leave anything, okay. So that is why I am making each and every video, kyunki seekhna ban to jeetna ban, seekhte raho jeetne ke liye. So here we end the topic called scope of management accounting. Only 8 points are there, some 3 paragraphs, decision making, planning, organizing, controlling, these 3. For these 3, 8 subpoints are been there. So keep it in mind, learn the things. I am saying it once again, after this lockdown, you people will not get enough time for the preparation also, records, internals, much things will come. So be prepared. So don't waste the time, prepare yourself better, okay. Lastly, share it with your friends, kyunki sharing is caring. Stay home, stay safe. Jai Hind.